Well, hello. So, it seems like just a few months ago, I was getting all of my plants out of the plant room, and I was setting them out everywhere, especially here on my plant altar table. It's just a big granite table I have out in my garden, and I put lots of, you know, agave pups, aloes, just different things I like to enjoy. Well, it's time now in October to put them back in the plant room. So that's what I'm doing today. I'm starting to put and amass all of my plants together. I load them up on the gator because the plant room is at the main farm. I've done a video on the plant room before and shown kind of what I do and how I retrofitted an old room. And I thought, you know what? It'd be good for you to see this year's because guess what? It only gets fuller. It only gets more busy, but it still is good. All these plants have just been kind of thriving all summer long. They kind of thrive on neglect. Some of them I kind of took off of other plants and they maybe needed help or weren't looking so good. So they're still in stages of growth and hopefully getting better. But look at some of these beauties as they sit here in full sun. They're just gorgeous. I love different aloe and agave like this one. You do have to be careful, of course, they're pokey. So you have to be careful because they can hurt you. That's why I wear gloves, long sleeves. When I'm putting plants away, my thing is, if you have a nice day, you might as well do it. Don't wait till it's too cold. I live in zone 5 in Iowa, which means none of these are winter hardy. They wouldn't last outside. They would be way too cold. They would freeze, they would die. And for some reason, I feel like we gardeners often want things that don't grow in our area. So we find ways to have them and get them to grow. So I'm gonna fill up the rest of my gator. We're gonna take them over. Oh, I always think this one's really pretty. It's just like it's like almost cake-like. It's just so pretty how it has so many layers. You can see, I love each one. I love them all. Oh, and that one's blooming. They're kind of usually at their prime as soon as I have to take them in. They've been growing. I mean, look at aloe blooms. We don't get enough of these. That's just beautiful. Look at how they have little trumpet likes. Hummingbirds love them too. You know, it's fall in Iowa. When everywhere you walk, you just get accosted by spider webs, and these plants are too. So I try to, as I take them in, clean them up. If there's dead on them, I could try to take that off, kind of assess what the plant needs. I feel like we should do that for ourselves too, but we just don't as much. Oh, this little baby one was a friend this year. He gave it to me, Jim. Jim, if you're watching, it's thriving, it's beautiful. Look how it has little pink edges on it. That's what I love. When you notice those little fun things, as I try to pack it up, I sometimes have to give them, I have to kind of jiggle it around because the sharp pointy ends can cause them to break if they get pushed too hard. And so I want to make sure that they don't break or puncture other plants. So I try to finagle. It's kind of hard to get them all in. These two need to be split, so I'm gonna leave them so I can split them. You can kind of see that they're just getting way overgrown. Look how many of the pups are kind of coming out of them. They're containers, they're probably gonna suffocate themselves eventually, so I'm gonna make sure I can do something about those. Okay, let's go over. Oh. Guys, I almost forgot. Come on, buddy. Welcome to the plant room. Nothing pretty, but what this is literally an old building on the farm that we don't use anymore, an old livestock building. And the front little room here was a work room that is insulated. So I put in a few windows. I couldn't put in that many. Put in a south facing one, a north facing one, and two west facing ones, just to give as much sunlight as I can. And then what I do is have some, you know, grow lights, full spectrum grow lights, up above, as many as I can kind of put around. I might even actually add some more because I'm packing this place just as much as you can. And what this does is give me a place where I can keep my sun-loving, warm-loving, aloe, agave, tropical, ferns, all these things over the winter. So I'm able to bring things in here and I set them up. So I have different areas all over that I kind of set these things up and you can kind of see that. I look on like second hand and look for stainless steel restaurant kitchen pieces because stainless steel does not rust. So if I can find them, I love to have tables I can spread out some of these on to mimic where they are outside. All around the edges, I have just kind of nursery style plant stands. And they allow me to have three tiers where I can set things up. Now, guess what? I have it packed a little bit too close. Plants like room, especially indoors, just, you know, to help air circulation, squash diseases, things like that. But room is of the essence. I need the room. So I pack them pretty close and I have more to bring in. What's nice is the floor cement, it has massive drain. So I can just water however I want to, let it just run down, which works pretty well. And then I am able to not worry about it. So yes, a greenhouse someday is on the dream list. You know, we all have those. But until then, this works really well. I have all these little just cheap plastic trays, and that's what I try to put under all the plants, just somewhat to help with watering, help with a little bit of the mess. It makes it a little bit easier. I reuse them, I wash them year to year and disinfect them to make sure. But you can see, you're able to get more in than you think. The one thing I do, and I know I get asked this all the time, what do you do for bugs? Well, some get in. But what I do try to do is outside, I will try to hose them off sometimes as much as I need with a strong stream of water just to knock off some. And then I get concentrate of neem and I put neem on everything I can. So I will spray it with neem oil and that just helps somewhat, you know, or I also will use insecticidal soap and I will use all those things to try to just kind of quash and be preventative of what could be on it. So I will always have neem mixed up or my insecticidal soap, whatever I need, and I will use that as needed to make sure that everything is good. I kind of separate it just so I know on watering what one half maybe needs versus the other. On this side are a lot of my tropicals, like my large philodendrons, my birds of paradise, which got riddled in the wind. And so they're now gonna shoot out new leaves, which will be nice. I have my citrus over here where it can be right in front of a window, just because I wanna give them as much sun as they can get. And then my staghorn ferns are here, which I just split one of my big ones into two. So that will be a nice thing for over the winter. You know, this is kind of what's nice about it is, you could do this in a garage if you wanted to, in a basement, because most of the light's kind of artificial. But the thing is, it corrals them in one spot. So a lot of times people will be like, oh, isn't it a mess to have to water all this? It really isn't. One, it's nice in the middle of winter to come out here. I keep it around 70-ish to maybe 80 degrees. I just use two radiant heaters that are kind of like space heaters. And I like radiant because it doesn't do forced air. So it doesn't blow and make dry air. Instead, it keeps it just like radiant heat. So it isn't quite as dry, but it's nice in the middle of January when it could be zero or below. I come out here, it's warm. It has that greenhouse kind of smell and the humidity a little bit. And I just kind of tend to my plants. I water them. They don't dry out as quickly as you would think. And I can kind of just keep track of them. It's a nice thing to do. So this is kind of what I do. It's kind of working for me. Actually, it works really well. I don't usually have any dye. Maybe a fern if I forget to water it, but we've all been there. I give up on maidenhairs. They just hate me. Other than that though, it's what I do and it works really well. So I hope you're inspired to maybe save some plants. You don't have to become a crazy plant person like me, but it's addictive and you could. So I'm gonna go get a few more because you might think this looks full. It's not. So keep checking my stories. I'll be showing more about what I'm putting in here and how it's coming together.